Hey guys, Dallas Thomas here with Gadget Hacks. Today I'm going to show you how to remove any bloatware app without using root or a computer. Now to me, if an app came pre-installed on your phone and you can't remove it, that's bloatware. Usually though, that means busting out a PC so you can use ADB commands to remove it. One exception has been the Package Disabler Pro app for Samsung, but for one, that's a paid app that Samsung does their best to block, and for two, it doesn't work on non-Samsung phones. So we need a new way, one that doesn't require an external device. Well, thanks to a feature introduced in Android 9 and upgraded in Android 11, it's now possible to remove any pre-installed app entirely on phone and without root. The feature is tucked away in the hidden developer options menu, and on Android 11, it now involves a pairing process between your phone and itself. You'll see what I mean in just a minute. So to get started, head to Settings, then About Phone. And then on some phones, you may have to tap Software Information here. But once you see the build number entry, go ahead and tap it 7 times in quick succession to unlock developer options. You'll be asked to enter your lock screen passcode. And once you do, you'll find developer options either in Settings, System, Advanced, or just at the very bottom of the main settings menu. So head in there and scroll to the debugging section that isn't too far down. Now first, if you don't see a switch for wireless debugging, wireless ADB, or wireless ADB debugging, I'm sorry to tell you, but you're out of luck. This method won't work for you. Even though this feature is part of Android's open source code base, a few manufacturers have actually hidden it away in their OEM skins for Android 9 and 10. The brands that I was able to test here in the US all had it enabled, but I think Xiaomi and potentially some others have it disabled. That seems to have changed on Android 11 now that the feature has been finalized, and it looks like all phones have it now if they're updated. But for everybody else who's still here, go ahead and turn on the switch next to wireless debugging. Again, it may have a slightly different name from phone to phone, so just make sure to turn on the wireless option, whatever it's called. Now what you'll need to do is create a local ADB server on your phone and connect it to this feature. There are a few different apps that can do this, like Remote ADB Shell, but those require you to manually trigger the connection, which can be a little hard. So instead, I'd recommend LADB, as in local ADB, which was purpose-built for exactly this. It does cost $2.99 on the Play Store, but if you're comfortable compiling an app from source, you can get it for free from GitHub. Still, I'd recommend the Play Store route for easier updates. But once you've got it installed, go ahead and open it up. Now, if you're on Android 9 or 10, all you'll have to do here is tap Allow on a prompt. But if you're on Android 11, there's now a passcode system involved here. And because the passcode regenerates as soon as you close the box that shows it, you'll need to open your settings app in split screen view while you type it in. So open the multitasking screen and tap LADB's icon at the top of its card, then choose split screen on the pop-up. Now, most phones will show your other recent apps on half of the screen, in which case you just have to choose the settings app you just had open to jump right back into developer options. But on Samsung, you'll get this little app drawer where you'll have to reopen settings, and then you can drill back into the developer options menu from there. Here, scroll down to the debugging section again, and this time tap the actual wireless debugging text, not the toggle, to open a submenu. And here, scroll down and tap pair device with pairing code. Here, you'll see your IP address, followed by a colon, and then another number. That other number is your port number, so type that into the port field in LADB, and then type the pairing code into the other box. Once you've done that, leave split screen open until you get a wireless debugging connected notification. Now you're ready to remove some bloatware, but first you'll need to know the bloatware app's package name, which is essentially the name your operating system knows it by. The easiest way to do that is to grab an app called Package Name Viewer 2.0. Once you've got that installed for free from the Google Play Store, open it up and use the search field at the top of the screen to find the app you want to remove. Tap it, then select Copy on the pop-up. Now open your favorite note-taking app, something where you can edit text. Go ahead and paste your clipboard's contents into a note, and you'll notice there's a lot more than just a package name copy. So put your cursor right after the colon that follows the word package, and then delete everything before that point. Then highlight the word launcher, which starts with a capital L, and then also select everything after that and delete it. Now you should be left with a plain package name in a format like com.abc.xyz. Go ahead and copy that. From there, head back to LADB and start entering the command that will disable the bloatware app. Type PM followed by a space, then uninstall followed by a space, then two hyphens, then the word user followed by a space, then a zero followed by a space, then paste in the package name. So pm uninstall hyphen hyphen user zero package name. Go ahead and hit enter, then you should see a success message. The app is now disabled and all associated data has been deleted except for the initial APK. It will stay that way until you factory reset your phone or send another command to reinstall it. That one would be pm space install hyphen existing in a space, then two hyphens and the word user followed by a space, then the number zero followed by a space, then the package name. But for more help with this whole thing, be sure to check out the full written guide over on gadgethacks.com. And as always, we'd appreciate it if you would like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel. So we'll see you again next time, folks. But until then, happy gadget hacking.